So I'm in Utah for work right now, but I thought as I'm busting out of the hotel for a little bit to go on a hike that I would talk to you about the Great Salt Lake and Water Conservancy.
There's so many birch trees. I love birch trees.
While I'm up here hiking in this beautiful state park,
it's worth noting that like California, Utah is also in a drought, but a lot of the water issues happening with the Great Salt Lake are only compounded and made worse by the drought, because as lush and green as it is in these mountains, there is definitely a water shortage, and it's caused by people. 2015 showed some of the lowest water levels the lake had ever seen. Water levels are actually so low that the marina had to pull all of the boats out. A study from Utah State University released a paper that said over the last 150 years, something like 11 feet have dropped in the natural water level. Plus, if you add onto that 3 more feet from this drought, it's about 14 feet lower than it should be. Basically, the water issues here have been around for a lot longer than this drought, and the drought is not the root cause. So some stats about the Great Salt Lake. It's 75 miles long by 35 miles wide, and it's the last remnants, the saltwater remnants of Lake Bonneville, which was a pluvial lake that covered basically this whole area.
3 large rivers feed into the lake. They are the lake's only water supply. As more and more water gets diverted from feeder rivers for agricultural use, the lake's water level drops. What's actually impressive is that water conservation efforts have managed to reduce the urban per capita water use by 18% in recent years. But unfortunately, the overall municipal water use has risen 5%, again, mostly due to agriculture. In cases like these, arguing for continued individual reduction, things like shorter showers and not watering your lawn, are good and important, but actual and effective water conservation is needed. And that means lawmakers need to get involved, or powerful community action.
From my understanding, as kind of a tourist top-down perspective, there's a lot of debate about adding more dams above the Salt Lake and how to better manage the water. But what's really important is that policymakers and citizens' initiatives try to reduce the amount of water we're taking out and diverting away from the Salt Lake.
Because the Great Salt Lake is an important fixture in the community and the environment. If the water levels continue to drop at this rate, the lake could go the way of many other inland waters, like the Aral Sea or Owens Lake, and that would have rippling consequences. The Salt Lake is one of the most saline inland bodies of water in the world, and
while a lot of people like to compare it to like the Dead Sea, it's actually a huge important ecosystem. It's a major stopping point for migratory birds and provides, I think, $1.3 billion in economic industry to the area.
Without an outlet, the deposits of salts from the rivers that flow into the Great Salt Lake never leave. So the basin is filled with sodium, chloride, potassium, sulfate, and magnesium, all mineable minerals that are part of the community's economy. And economic benefits aside, over 7.5 million shorebirds utilize the lake, representing 275 different species. And at times, over half the North American population, over 2.5 million of eared grebes, which are these funky birds with red eyes, hang out by its waters. And if you like pelicans or phalaropes, it's got those too. It's also worth mentioning that Utah's state capital is Salt Lake City. The Great Salt Lake has incredible cultural relevancy, and we should try not to let it dry up.
Water conservancy is a huge topic across the entire US, and particularly in the Southwest. Sometimes it feels like water is just something that's super easy to come by, it just flows out of our tap, but as countless places have showed us, it is an important resource that we need to take care of. My friend also wants me to mention that the Salt Lake is full of brine shrimp, like full. In fact, it's a huge part of the economy. And according to a quick Google search, those little sea monkeys make up a multi-million dollar commercial industry. Probably not for sending them to space or little kid science projects, but for use of feed and fishing for other things. Also, the brine shrimp are part of the reason why the Salt Lake is such a major part of the ecosystem. They make for great treats for migratory birds. I don't know how people do it. This vlogging thing is really hard. I do not have the bicep strength for it.